In this video, we'll compare Node.js with Golang. I'll use standard library to create a web application in Golang. And for the Node.js, I'll use Express, a very common web framework. To run these tests, I deploy both applications to a production-ready Kubernetes cluster in AWS and use latest generation EC2 instances as Kubernetes nodes. First, we'll measure CPU usage, memory usage, application availability, CPU throttling by Kubernetes, and network pressure. We'll also track how many bytes each application receives and transmits. This can vary a lot based on the number of headers and whether application uses keep alive, which allows a single TCP connection to handle multiple HTTP requests. Now, for the second test, I introduce a persistence layer because most applications need to store the state in some way. In addition to other metrics, we'll measure latency for each application, specifically how long it takes to insert data into the database. And we'll also track the connection pool and how each application scales it. As a DevOps engineer, I rely on developer input to run and optimize applications in production environments. I welcome any advice on improving application, or even better, a pull request. You can find the link to my GitHub repo in the video description. Alright, let me go ahead and deploy both applications to Kubernetes. You can notice that Node uses slightly more CPU, and the memory usage is more or less the same. Alright, it's time to start the first performance test. I use Kubernetes job and 20 replicas to start generating load on each application. The entire test took maybe 3 or 4 hours, but I'll compress it to just a few minutes. I start with one client per pod and keep increasing the clients until both applications start to fail. Also, I have a 60-second interval between stages, and I set the client timeout to 1 second. When this timeout is reached, you'll see a drop in availability. From the start, you can notice that Node uses more CPU to process requests, and the latency is significantly larger than Go. I would say that it is similar in performance to the Python Django framework that I tested in the previous video. Besides that, Node uses more memory, and it also sends more headers by default. That's why you can see that it transmits more data. When we reach 9000 requests per second, Node reaches 60% CPU usage and gets stuck. If you know what's going on with Node and experienced this before, please let me know. For the remainder of the test, the CPU usage will be around 60%, and only the latency of the requests will increase. I know that you can use cluster mode, but personally, I think that simply increasing the number of replicas would be better for Node.js. And since I use exactly the same setup as for the previous tests, we know that Golang can handle around 70 or 80,000 requests. And since Golang standard library doesn't have any rate limiting, it will keep caching all the requests until it reaches 100% memory usage and gets killed by Kubernetes. By the end of the test, Node also started to degrade and many requests started to time out, which you can see in the availability graph. By the way, I used async functions for Node and set Node ENV to production. So the results: Go can handle around 70,000 requests per second, and Node around 9,000. Now, let me open each graph for the entire test duration. First, we have requests per second. Then P99 client latency. And the latency before Node started to slow down. Next is CPU usage graph. Memory usage. Availability graph. CPU throttling. And finally, network pressure. Alright, that's pretty much all for the first test. If you have any suggestions on how to improve these tests, please let me know. Now, let's do the second test. In this test, we sent a POST request with JSON payload to each application. The app then generates UUID for the device and saves it to a database. Also, I have set a maximum connection pool size of 20 for both applications. I use open source Postgres Docker image to run some migrations. For example, I create a user, clean up all idle connections for a particular database user, and create a table. Then I use init container to run those migrations every time I deploy application. Let's go ahead and start. I used one of the fastest Postgres drivers for Node. So it looks like the latency to insert data is more or less the same at the beginning of the test. The overall latency is also close to each other. But of course, CPU and memory usage are very different. You can also notice that connection pool quickly reaches the maximum size of 20 connections per application. By around 4,000 requests per second, you can see that it again reaches 60% CPU usage and starts to degrade. The latency goes up, and it looks like that is the maximum number of requests for Node in this test. Let's keep going until Golang starts to fail. At around 7,000 requests per second, you can see that it gets stuck and only memory usage goes up. If you just continue the test, it also hits the memory limit and gets killed by Kubernetes. Alright, let me open each graph for the entire test duration. First, we have requests per second, client latency, database latency, connection pool size, CPU usage, memory usage, availability, and finally we have CPU throttling. If you know how to improve each application, please send me a pull request. Also, I have another playlist with similar benchmarks. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.